You first need Stable Diffusion XL 0.9 base model, which has been leaked on Hugging Space. Since it got taken down earlier, you now need to fill this form, but don't worry, it gets auto-approved and you can enter anything. It is recommended to not enter your real details. After you get access, click on this download button next to the saved tensor file, which is around 13 GB. You don't need any other file to run it locally. Now, automatic level 11 support is on the way, but till then you can use ComfyUI, which is easy to set up and already has SDXL 0.9 support. From the GitHub, you can click on the direct download page, but just to be sure that I'm downloading the up-to-date version, I like to go to the releases and download the latest release. Once it has been downloaded, extract the file. Now, please read the README for instructions, but basically we need to add at least one model or checkpoint first. Copy the SDXL 0.9 base model into the checkpoints folder inside the models inside ComfyUI. Now you can double click start nvidia.bat if you have an NVIDIA GPU or the CPU file otherwise. I also like to first open the terminal and then run the file to have a better idea of what's actually going on. This will launch the Comfy Web UI and that's it. As you can see, it auto-loads the SDXL checkpoint. Apart from that, you can enter positive prompts as well as negative prompts. You can and should change these settings here. You can also add a new node for the refiner model, which will significantly improve the generated image. Then click the Queue button. Let's try the same prompts that I tried on Clip Drop earlier and compare. It might not be as good since we are currently not using the refiner model, which refines the output further. I'll make another video about this later, so subscribe. The outputs are kind of bad, to put it nicely. It makes sense since not only are we not using the refiner, which is essential, but the default settings aren't really good for SDXL. Increasing the number of steps or changing the scheduler affects it significantly, but it also increases the amount of time taken to generate the image. I'll be covering the best settings for SDXL along with the refiner and using it with smaller graphics card in future videos, so do make sure to subscribe.